Welcome to class 7 English reader, last lesson of the afternoon by D.H. Lawrence. About the poet. D.H. Lawrence is regarded as one of the most influential writers of the 20th century. He published many novels and poetry volumes during his lifetime. He was a famous English novelist, poet, essayist, playwright, literary critic and painter. Last lesson in the afternoon was written by Lawrence at the time he was teaching in Croydon, near London. By this time, in England, the government had made education compulsory. Many pupils had no desire to learn, but were still forced to attend school. He felt that time at the school was futile, and the time he was trying to teach them was to a complete waste. Ultimately, he abandoned teaching and made up his mind to be a full-time author. Short summary of the poem. The poem, Last Lesson of the Afternoon by D.H. Lawrence. The poem begins with a teacher describing his weariness and stating that he can no longer teach his students who have no interest to learn. The teacher essentially feels hopeless and questions the purpose of teaching and feels that his students are akin to pack of unruly hounds. He is tired of them and doesn't want to waste his energy dispensing knowledge to his students who are not all interested in learning. At last, teacher concludes by telling that it is easier to wait for the bell to ring rather than making students learn. Now I am going to recite the poem line by line so you can go through it. Last lesson of the afternoon. When will the bell ring and end this weariness? How long have they tugged the leash and strained apart? My pack of unruly hounds I cannot start. Them again on a quarry of knowledge they hate to hunt. I can haul them and urge them no more. No longer now can I endure the brunt of the books that lie out on the desk a full threescore, of several insults of bloated pages and scrawl, of slovenly work that they have offered me. I am sick, and what on earth is the good of it all? What good to them or me I cannot see. So shall I take my last dear fuel of life to heap on my soul, and kindle my will to a flame that shall consume their dross of indifference and take the toll of their insults in punishment. I will not. I will not waste my soul and my strength for this. What do I care for all that they do amiss? What is the point of this teaching of mine and of this learning of theirs? It all goes down the same abyss. What does it matter to me if they can write a description of a dog or if they can't? What is the point to us both? It is all my aunt, and yet I am supposed to care with all my might. I do not and will not. They won't and they don't, and that's all. I shall keep my strength for myself. They can keep theirs as well. Why should we beat our heads against the wall of each other? I shall sit and wait for the bell. By D.H. Lawrence. Here are some home assignments for you all. With the help of a dictionary, find out the meanings of the following words and write in your copy. You can see number A, weariness; B, lease; C, quarry; D, endure; E, brunt; F, threescore; G, slovenly; H, dross; I, indifference; J, abyss. So use your dictionary and write down in your copy. Here are some of the question answers. You can read and write it down in your copy. Number 1. Which idea does the poem begin and end with? Answer. The poem begins with the idea of the period coming to an end with the ringing of the bell. Number 2. What metaphor does the poet use in the first stanza of the poem? With which words is this metaphor expressed? Answer. The metaphor used in the first stanza of the poem is unruly hounds. The metaphor has been sustained with words like slovenly, work, same abyss, heads against the wall, with all my might, lease. Number 3. Why does the poet think of his pupils as a pack of unruly hounds? Answer. The poet thinks of his pupils as a pack of unruly hounds because they do not want to study. They blot the pages, scrawl slovenly, show indifference, and do not want to learn anything. Question number 4. What is the insult that the poet refers to in stanza 3? Answer. The insult that the poet refers to in stanza 3 is a full 3 score of bloated pages. Question number 5. In stanza 3, the poet seems angry. Why? Answer. The poet is angry as his time and energy as well as his knowledge seems to be getting wasted as the children are too indifferent and show no interest in learning. Question number 6. What is the poet's final decision or resolve? Answer. The poet's final decision or resolution is that he shall keep his strength for himself as well as their strength and not beat his head against the wall. He too shall wait for the bell to ring. Last question, number 7. Give 2 examples of the use of metaphors in the poem. Answer. Quarry of knowledge and fuel of life are 2 metaphors used in the poem. Quarry of knowledge. Knowledge is compared to a prey that is being hunted. Thank you, and hope it will be useful for you all.